Well, what's the difference from the 1930s? Several things. One thing that's different is large-scale labor action. The 1930s were the period of the organization of the CIO. In the 1920s, the U.S. labor movement had been virtually destroyed. Remember, we have this is very much a business-run society. American labor history is very violent, quite unlike comparable countries. And by the 1920s, the quite effective militant labor movement had been pretty much crushed. One of the great works of labor history by David Montgomery, one of the great labor historians, is called The Rise and Fall of the American Labor Movement. He was talking about the 1920s, when it had essentially been destroyed. The 1930s, it revived. It revived with large-scale organizing activities. CIO organizing began. The strike actions were quite militant. They led to sit-down strikes. A sit-down strike is a real sign of warning to the business classes, because there's a step beyond a sit-down strike. The next step beyond a sit-down strike is, let's start the factory by running by ourselves. We don't need the bosses. We can run it ourselves. So get rid of them, okay? That's a real revolution, the kind that should take place. The participants in an enterprise would own and run it by themselves, instead of being the slaves of the private owners who control their lives. And a sit-down strike is a bare step away from that. That aroused real fear among the ownership classes.